Hello everyone, welcome to the Java course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the while loop. If we want to control the iteration of some repetitive tasks, we can make use of the while loop to help us do the things according to our given conditions. If the condition is still held, we can continue the loop until the condition fails. So then let's see some examples. Suppose I have three values. One is called savings, one is called month, and one is called target. I want to save some money until I reach the target. That is my intention of repeatedly adding money to my account so that I can save some money towards my target. And then, how can I do the savings? I can do something like this in order to reach my target. I want to say while the savings is less than or equal to the target, I will add money to the account. I want to print out the amount of my savings in a particular month. And after doing the printing, I have to save some money to my account. So I have to change the savings variable together with the month variable. After the savings amount is already large enough towards the target, I can finish the loop and say that I have already reached the target. I can have a statement like this, so let me save it and run it to see the effect. Okay, initially the amount is zero, so I will start with zero in month zero, and after month one, I'm going to save some amount, and after month 2, I will have this amount, and in month 6, I will have $9,000. And when I want to save some more money in month 7, I will get $10,500, which is already beyond the target. So the condition shown here already fails. In this case, I will leave the while loop and do the printing of my current amount in my savings account. I also print out the number of months needed to reach the savings that is beyond my target. So after printing out the statement inside the while loop, I need to change the amount of the savings and the month by this amount and that amount accordingly. Otherwise, we will end up with an endless loop. So let us see the result. If I forget the addition of $1,500 in my savings account during the for loop, during the while loop. Let me save it and run it. okay, I need to stop it. The amount never increases, even though the month increases. So if I don't update the savings amount, this condition always holds because the savings is always equal to zero, which is of course smaller than or equal to the target. So I will have an endless loop, which is not desirable. So that's why we have to consider the change of the condition state in the while loop. Otherwise, we will end up with an endless loop. When we use a while loop, we need to consider the floating point precision issue very carefully. It is possible that the precision issue will make our while loop fail. So let us see an example. So I have to say that we have to take care when we use some floating point numbers as our loop control variable. The loop control variable is actually the thing mentioned in the while loop condition. So in my previous example, savings is known as the loop control variable. So when the loop control variable is a floating point number, it is possible that we can't use the while loop very successfully. Suppose I have a car and the speed of that car is this amount, 60.1 kilometers per hour. I want to speed up my car bit by bit. I want my speed to increase to 60.7 kilometers per hour. How can I do the increment of my speed? I would increase the speed by 0.1 kilometers per hour. So I'm able to change the value of the loop control variable by adding 0.1 to the original value of my speed. If my target of 60.7 kilometers per hour is reached, I can print out the speed by leaving the while loop first. Let me save it and run it to see the result. Okay, when we get the printing result on the console, there is some problem with it. According to our while loop, we expect that we will do the printing of the string when the speed is exactly equal to 60.7 kilometers per hour. But in our implementation, we can't do so by printing out the whole string mentioned in the while loop. Instead, we will go outside the while loop and print the value of the speed, which is larger than 60.7 kilometers per hour by a tiny amount. Why is that the case? Because for each addition of 0.1 to the original value of speed, it is possible that we will incur some precision issue, which make the value not equal to our desired value. So originally I want the speed to be exactly equal to 60.7 when I do the while loop, but it is not allowed. So the training statement inside the while loop is not able to show that the speed can reach 60.7 kilometers per hour exactly. So that's the problem when we use some floating point numbers as the loop control variable. In order to better ensure that we are able to achieve our looping conditions successfully, we can consider using integers as the loop control variable. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.